So, today, Chine, everyone, it's the continuation of the module 2, which is Text and Multimedia Lesson 8, which is the fun type. So, as I said, my last video, I'm going to continue this lesson. So, our topic for this day, which is the fun type. So, fun types is font or typefaces are the distinct style or text character that convey unique personality and mood. So, from the timeless elegance of serif fonts to the clean contemporary appeal of sans serif, the world of typography offers rich tips try of expressive option for designers. So basically, can you not fun types like serif fonts, the clean like sans serif. So ay na mga fun types is mga tackle nato, for instance nga, para may wala nato sa itong mga types. So next is the 7 types of fonts. So basic sa Kuanjo, this they have a 5 font types. So 7 types, so sana lang siya 5. So which is serif fonts, lab serif fonts, sans serif script, then handwritten fonts. So nara ko gidagdag nga duha, which is kaning monoscript font and display font. So presensya na mo sa kuan sa paan the chicken. Next, first is the serif font. So the serif font, they have kumbaga, this is the traditional ay kumbaga ani ang yang paan aning tawag ni character niya. So tradition and elegance. So serif fonts with the small strokes at the end of each letter exude a classic sophisticated look that is often associated with print media, especially books and newspapers. So kung makita nato sa mga books, kaniyang murag ang mga kuan ato kanang mga ginagamit nga font ato nga o ginasulat ato nga font type, which is kaning serif font. So napon siya yung kuan nga readability. So subtitle serif guides the eye along the text, making serif fonts highly legible and easy to read, particularly in long form content. So double masyado din ang serif font. So they have a Times appeal, which is the beloved serif type faces like Times New Roman, Georgia, and Garamond have stood the test of time, maintaining their popularity for centuries. So kumbaga kaniyang mga example nato nga mga font types sa kumbaga kaniyang murag ahom sa serif font na mga fonts. So kaniyang like Times or New Roman. So basically murag nakabalo naman tanan like sa mga Microsoft. Makita nato ni sila nga mga fonts. So next is the sans serif font. So di ba simplicity and clarity, legibility on screen, versatility, contemporary aesthetic. So si sans serif is with straight edge serifless design, convey a sense of modernity and simplicity, making them ideal for digital interfaces and UI elements. So basically murag ginagamit ni nga mga fonts sa instance sa mga like UI design, like for example kaning give ko na order nga example kaning murag sa web nga makita nato. So this is a for example nga sans serif font. So next is legibility on screens. Though the lack of serifs allows sans serif fonts to maintain their readability even at small sizes, making them popularity choices for web and mobile application. As I said kanang umaga, bisang although gamay lang siya, pero kaninga fonts which is readable masyado po sa in our screen, especially kung nagabuhat ang web and mobile application. So next is the versatility. So sans serif like Arial, Helvetica, and Verdana work well variety on context from headlines and titles to the body text, contributing to their widespread use. So kumbaga kaning mga Arial, so kaning Arial murag common man sa to, kumbaga kaniyang mga usay kung murag ahom sa sans serif fonts. So kaning Arial, Helvetica, and Verdana. So next is the contemporary aesthetic. So the clean minimalist appearance of sans serif fonts align with modern design trends, lending a sophisticated cutting edge feel to visual composition. So kaning fonts sans serif na siya pagka aesthetic gamay nga contemporary aesthetic nga pormada sa iyahang pagkasulat, which is kumbaga makita nato limpyo lang masyado, minimalist lang masyado, then Next one is the slab serif fonts. So, slab serif fonts, which is distinctive presence. So, slab serif fonts with their thick, blocky serif and stand out with a strong, so robust visual presence, making them ideal for headlines, logos, and branding. So, anong slab serif, which is na siya distinct presence. So, murag ginagamit to rin is sa mga headline, logos, and branding. So, as kasi kaning, like for example, kaning gibuan na workshop. So, kumbaga, one of the examples na pagkasulat or fonts, which is kaning sa slab serif fonts. So, they have also na siya characterized nga attention grabbing. So, the distinct design of slab serif such as Rockwell and Courier helps them capture the viewer's attention and convey a sense of authority or importance. So, next is versatile application. While slab serifs are often associated with industrial or vintage aesthetic, they can also be used more contemporary settings to add visual interest and impact. So, as we can see, kaning the workshop, murag, kung kita yung makakita ni in the koan, murag, uy, gwapo siya tanawon, murag nagagrab po siya attention sa tuwa, kung makita nato ni nga, fans. So, the next one is the script fans. So, they have expressive and distinctive, the artistic flair and versatile in branding. So, sa expressive and distinctive, so script font with their calligraphic and cursive styles and sense of elegance, sophistication and personal touch, the design often used for invitation titles and creative elements. So as you can see, murag na siya yung mga kuan nga like magka italic na formada kung kaning script font. So mga na design po kung mga need po siya sa in the titles and to creative elements. So next is artistic flair. So, the organic fluid nature of script fonts can enhance the artistic and artisanal qualities and of design, lending a bespoke and handcrafted feel. So, like, while script fonts may be challenging to use in large block of text, they can be effectively utilize logos and headline and other prominent design elements to create a distinct brand identity. So, kumbaga gani ang pasabot sa mga script fonts sa like for example kaning sa mga branding, kumbaga ginagamit po siya. So, the next one is the monospace font. So, monospace font. So, technical application, monospace fonts where each character occupies the same with are widely used in programming, coding, and technical documentation showing consist alignment and readability. So, they have also retro-aesthetic, the uniform appearance of monoface fonts like Courier New and Consolas can also evoke a nostalgic typewriter-like feel, adding a vintage charms to design. So, emphasize content. So, the lack of stylistic flourishes and monospace fonts help to shift the focus towards the content itself, making them ideal for application where readability and clarity are paramount. So, kaning monospace daw, which is kanong magita nato sa to ang mga visual code. So, katong font na ginagamit dito, kanong mga letter na nabutang dito, or kanang mga font is ginatawag nato nga monospace font. So, next one is the display font. So, they have a characteristic which is attention grabbing. So, display font with their highly decorative and eye-catching design are primarily used for headlines, titles, and other prominent design elements to instantly capture the viewer attention. For example, basically, kanang party. So, as we can see, kanang pinabutang nila dira sa ilahang, like, for example, kanang poster. Kanang ginagamit na dira nga mga mga attractive siya masyado through kanang mga murag kanang display kanang font derives ginata from the lower display font. So murag sabotable naman siya masyado. So they have a personality and mood. So the diverse range of display font from impactful slab serif to whimsical script allows design to convey specific moods, emotions, and personal through their typography choices. So basically murag sabotable naman masyado kung kaning display font mga nala based siya sa ato ang personality and mood, for example, kung mga example kanang parte party rather dapat na kanang paan mga makita nato ning 25 ching like this one sa akong example kung mga kung makaninyo o sa may mood na or personality na ma panato diri like for example kanang sa color pa lang which is murag makita nato nga ang mga kuan pa lang display nga gondri is murag like magkwanjo sa mga party-party like yan, ano. So next one is limited usage due to the for large blocks of text as their intricate design can reduce readability in smaller sizes. So nagpun siya yung na limited usage so due to their decorative nature so murag large kung mga din na masyado ginapanako for instance ka ng mga design bodies maayin but lang kung rin ako na siya maayos sa inyo. So, next one is the handwritten fonts. So, they have casual atmosphere. So, handwritten fonts with their organic imperfect strokes can create a warm, inviting, and casual atmosphere often used in branding, packaging, and editorial design. So, mga kaning handwritten fonts. So, next is, masasana ako ng mga characters. Personality and character. So, the unique personalized appearance of handwritten fonts adds sense of individuality and the characters making them a popular choice more expressive, more informal, authentic, and relatable tunes. So, the next one is legibility concern. So, while handwriting fonts can be visually appealing, they can pose challenge in terms of legibility, especially in larger bodies of text, and should be used judicially. So, more handwritten. So, mga ito ang kuan. Ito ang gina, more literal. Ito ang handwritten. Ito ang gina sulat. So, ito. Ako siya masyado ma-explain pero murag sabutable naman masyado from the word handwritten font. So the next one is the choosing the right font. So napunting na kuan choosing the right font kumbaga piliyo nato ang mga font nga sa tuwang kuan. So they have a three. So consider the context, balance, and hierarchy, and experiment and refine. So the choices of font should be guided by the overall design, the medium, and the target audience to ensure visual cohesion and effective communication. The last is balance. Second one is the balance hierarchy. Designer must carefully consider font pairing, sizes, and weight to establish a clear visual hierarchy and create a harmonious typographic composition. The last one is experiment and refine. So the selection of the right font is an interactive process that often requires exploration, testing, and refinement to arrive at the most suitable choices. So that's all for this lesson 8, which is the font type. So that's all. Thank you.